friends. Welcome back to our channel if you've seen our videos before. And if you are new, my name is Abby.
My name is Hope.
And we're
the Disney Sisters. Today we have another pin tag for you.
Yay!
So this is a brand new pin tag that we have created with our friend Cassidy from MagicalMartini here on YouTube. So we will go ahead and leave a link to her channel down in the description box.
Go check her out.
Cassidy has some awesome content. She does a lot of pin videos, pin tags, and things like that.
Yep.
And guys, Cassidy has the coolest collection. If you guys don't know, I have a collection that I call my older pins collection. So it's anything from like 2005 and later or earlier. And she actually has started her pin collection in 2000 when they started pin collecting in the parks. Like that was the year that it began. And she has pins from 2000 and on that were naturally collected by her. Like, I'm going back and trying to find them, but she already has them. Mm-hmm. So she has a really, really extensive collection. And so when she asked us to collab on this pin tag with her, we were like,
yeah,
yes, please. That sounds awesome. So truth be told, Cassidy did most of the work on this. She came up with most of the prompts herself and like, you know, made all the cute wording and everything.
That's awesome.
And yeah, we were just, you know, excited to be a part of it. And so at the end of this video, we are going to tag some people to do this tag as well. So this tag is called the Disney Parks Favorites Pin Tag. And we're going to be talking about all of our favorite things.
Disney
you know
Parks.
We guys love talking about favorites.
Yep.
And this is all Disney Park edition. So it's going to be super duper fun. So let's get into it. Question one, show a pin that represents your favorite Disney park. I think we have the same park
but different pins. So the pin that I chose for this, our favorite park is Epcot.
Yes.
You can probably tell by the ratio of Epcot vlogs to all the other vlogs on our channel.
It's true.
And it's only going to get worse from here, guys. The festivals are starting again.
Yes, food and wine. Yeah. We're a little excited about it.
But I picked this newer pin to my collection. This is the World Showcase Destinations Discovered tour pin. We just went on this tour with our friend Karen from Karen's USA Adventures. I'll link the vlog up there and in the description so you can go check it out. We had a great time. It was so much fun. This is an amazing tour.
And in that vlog, we show some footage of the tour itself. If you want to get a glimpse of what's involved in the tour, you should
check out that vlog. But I love this pin. I love the color scheme. I think it's so pretty, and it really represents Epcot to me because you've got like
Spaceship Earth,
but you've also got the World Showcase, and it's really, really cool. This is the one that I picked for Epcot.
So my favorite park is Epcot as well, but I went for this oldie but goodie pin. This is a 2000 Walt Disney World pin. So it is the Spaceship Earth ball right in the middle. Spaceship Earth is my absolute favorite. I love it. It's from our favorite park, so it just...
It makes
me happy every time I see it. And then it has Sorcerer Mickey's hand coming up with a wand, which back in the day, the park used to have Mickey's hand with a wand like sticking up. It was like a monument type thing that was there. Not a monument, but like a, I don't know, like a statue that was there. And so this, it was two elements that were in the park. Now the hand is no longer there, but Spaceship Earth still is. So that is on this pin. This one is from 2000, and yeah, I really like this one. Question two, a pin that represents your favorite Disney park land.
So for this one, my favorite land at Magic Kingdom is Frontierland. So I picked this cute little Splash Mountain pin. It looks like a postage stamp, and it's very, very cute. While Splash Mountain is not my favorite ride in Frontierland,
I really
don't care for Splash Mountain, but I love the storyline, and I love the music, but I don't love the actual ride. But my favorite is Thunder Mountain. But I love Frontierland, and Splash Mountain's kind of the iconic... It's one of the iconic parts of Frontierland. Like, you can see it from the distance, and it's just, like, looming over everything. So I really like this pin. It's very cute. And it makes me think of Frontierland. Yeah. And just the whole thing has very much, like, a Western America vibe, and I like it.
I actually, I don't know if this is cheating, but I technically did not go with a Magic Kingdom land, even though those are the only ones that are, like, officially called lands.
Yeah.
But I actually went with the World Showcase of Epcot, because technically, in my mind, the World Showcase is a land, and then Future World is a land.
And then in Animal Kingdom, there's Africa, there's Asia, there's
Discovery. Yeah, so I do think other parks, and, like, Toy Story Land, Star Wars Land. So I think there are different, definitely different lands in all the parks. They're just not called that.
And just the Magic Kingdom ones are, like, the iconic.
Right. Yeah. And so I went with the World Showcase of Epcot, and this is my favorite pavilion, and that is America. It is the direct furthest away from the front of the park, but it is so just beautiful. Mm-hmm. I love looking at it. I love hanging out there. Now, they are doing some renovations in it right now, so it's not as peaceful as it normally is. But I have no doubt that it will be back to its beautiful self after they're done with the renovations. So this one is one of the new Food and Wine Festival mystery pins. This one is Mickey Mouse standing in front of the America Pavilion. It has one of the foods from the food booth for Food and Wine, and he has a lobster roll in front of him, so you really couldn't get more American. So this one, is limited release from the Food and Wine Festival mystery box. Question 3, a pin that represents your favorite Disney park castle. So I think we both have the same castle, but again, different pins.
Yeah, but I mean, I haven't seen any of the other castles in person. So that may change in my lifetime, but...
But I still feel like Walt Cinderella. Disney World will be our favorite because it's still our home park and it's where all the memories are.
And just Cinderella's castle is just stunning. So pretty. It's so nice. So we both went, I think, with a Cinderella's castle pin. Mine is from the 45th anniversary of the Magic Kingdom, which was a few years ago. I want to say it was like
2016.
So this is just a really cute pin. Like it's made out of the metal and then there's just a little bit of enamel at the bottom. But I think it looks really cool and very like chic and nice and very classic.
Yeah.
I think it's really cool. So, yeah. We were there for the 45th anniversary and we got this pin then and it makes me happy.
Yeah. So, I again chose Cinderella's Castle, but I chose a different pin. This is another one from my older pins collection and this is a Night of Joy 2000 pin. So, we've talked about on our channel before how much we loved Night of Joy. It was a night when all of, a bunch of Christian artists would come into the Magic Kingdom and set up stages everywhere, and it was a mix of, like, concerts, and you could ride rides, and it was just a wonderful time. It was after park hours, so it was, like, a through-the-night thing. So you'll actually notice in this pin that it's a darker background because it represents being at night.
I mean, it's Night of Joy,
It's Night of Joy, and so this one says, your night, your music, your kingdom, and that, I guess, must have been, the slogan for that year. Question 4, a pin that represents your favorite Disney park ride.
Okay, so I could have gone with a lot of answers for this one, but I feel like because he is my biggest collection, I have to put a Figment pin. Like, it's gotta be Figment.
Yeah.
Journey into Imagination is one of my favorite rides. It makes me so happy. Yeah. And I know a lot of people don't like it, but they can just be sad off by themselves. And I will just ride it. If they just don't want to get on in line, then I can just go as many times as I want. And I'll be perfectly happy. So this pin was from the Festival of the Arts 2017, I think. This was the inaugural year. Yeah. And for the Figment's Brush with the Master Scavenger Hunt, which we'll link this year's vlog up there somewhere. These were the prizes the very first year they handed out pins, which was so cool.
And that is the only year of any scavenger hunt that they've actually had pins as the prize.
Yep.
It was phenomenal.
So I picked this one. There are 4 different designs and I do have them all, but this is the one I feel that represents the ride the best because he's here in his blue sparkles squeezing a tube of Figment pigment out of it, and it makes me think of the ride and that particularly that like end scene where it's all
rainbows
and glitter and
looks like
imagination.
A kid's art project really
blew up on the ride. Yep, that's what it looks like. But this is a limited release pin from Festival of the Arts 2017. And I really like it, and he's really cute on it, so it makes me happy. Cute.
The pin that I chose for my favorite ride is, of course, Soarin'. So this pin is actually older, and it's from the Soarin', California version, but I think it doesn't say that it's from California, so I think it could kind of work for both, because I really do love the Soarin' Around the World, like the new version, but I do love both mm-hmm. equally. But this pin is from 2005, and it's just Mickey, Pluto, and Goofy on the hang glider from Soarin', and it moves back and forth. And they're kind of panicking because they look like they're gonna fall, but it's just a really, really fun pin. And Soarin' is probably my favorite ride, if not like top two. So yeah, I have this Soarin' pin. Question five: a pin that represents your favorite character encounter you've had in the parks.
So we've had a lot of incredible character encounters mm-hmm. on.
We really have, yeah.
But I'm going with this brand new Food and Wine Festival 2019 pin that we just picked up a couple weeks ago now. And this is one of the new limited edition pins that I love so much. So this is Pooh and Piglet in Owl's house reaching for the honey, and there's a moving element. It slides back and forth, like when the house is like rocking back and forth in the wind. The back, it says Epcot International Food and Wine Festival.
It's hanging up on the wall.
Yeah. But the reason that I picked this is Pooh and Piglet both are two of my favorite characters to meet in the parks. So they're both just so like snuggly, and they're good mm-hmm. to hug, and they're so cute, and it makes me happy. Recently, on the first day of the Food and Wine Festival, they did a special pass holder meet and greet for Pooh.
Yes.
In Christopher Robin's room in the UK Pavilion, and it was
so cool.
Magical. And I loved it, and so this makes me think of that, and it was one of my favorite meet and greets ever. So yeah, that's why I picked that pin.
So my favorite meet and greet that we've probably ever had, and mm-hmm. this has been multiple times, so my favorite character to meet, I guess, because I've had multiple interactions with her, is Merida. She is a fantastic meet and greet. Anytime that you go to Magic Kingdom, I highly recommend meeting Merida. Mm-hmm. She is funny and quick. She has quick wit, yeah. And she just always has a story to tell you, either about her brothers or herself, or just, she's always got so much to say. But this is the Merida dress from the Mystery Pin Box Lunch set, where it had a bunch of princesses' dresses. But this pin is gorgeous. It's glittery and sparkly and beautiful. So mm-hmm. Merida is definitely one of my favorite meet and greets ever. Question six, a pin that represents your favorite Disney park snack. Now for this one, I think we both went the same direction.
Yep.
Different pins again.
Yep.
But we went again with Epcot and festival food.
Yes.
Festival food is by far our favorite snack, meal, thing to get at the parks.
Yep.
Because they literally have a bit of everything. Mm-hmm. If you're feeling dessert one day, you can do that. If you're feeling, you know, steak, if you're feeling vegetarian soup, they have everything. So this is definitely by far our favorite thing to go. Our favorite place to go blow money is Food and Wine on the food booths.
Because they're
so good.
So the pin that I picked is another one of the new this year pins. This is from the mystery box
set.
You know what I'm talking about. But this is Winnie the Pooh in the UK Pavilion. You can see like the UK Pavilion outline behind him, which I think is so cool. Mm-hmm. And then this is the Irish pudding from the Ireland Pavilion, booth thing, which is the only one that's in the UK.
The other cool thing about Food and Wine, sorry, I just
totally
interjected,
cut me off,
is that one of my favorite things about the Food and Wine is that they actually give food booths for countries that aren't in the World Showcase normally.
Mm-hmm.
So you've got like Ireland,
India,
you've got
Brazil,
Africa. Well, Africa is already in there, but it's not official. Whatever.
Yeah.
You get a bunch of others.
Hawaii, like there's the islands
Caribbean.
Yeah. There's all sorts of things.
So it's really cool because you can eat from countries that aren't normally there.
Represented in the showcase.
Yeah.
So this is a really cute pin, and I love Pooh's face. He's like, I'm going to eat that, and it's going to be good. It's not honey, but I'll settle. I'll settle for the pudding.
So I also did a Food and Wine pin for the food goodies from Epcot, and this one is from 2016, and it is the Food and Wine Festival Figment pin, and Figment is a chef in this pin, and he is serving a tray of delicious foods looks like a milkshake, a piece of cake, and a taco. This one says Epcot International Food and Wine Festival 2016, and it has Figment standing in front of Spaceship Earth, and Spaceship Earth is actually like a see-through stained glass element, which is really cool. And this one is a limited release pin as well. Question 7. A pin that represents your favorite Disney park activity. Rides, shopping, people watching, etc. You name it. Whatever your favorite thing to do in the parks, that is this prompt.
So for this one, I picked something that I don't do nearly enough of, or this is to represent something I don't do nearly enough of that I love to do when I do it. Mm-hmm. But I don't do it nearly
as often, yeah,
as I would like to. But that's looking at animals at Animal Kingdom. I love just walking the trails. I love riding Kilimanjaro safaris over and over again. I love looking at the animals and the wildlife. It's so, so cool. So this is the Magic of Honor brand new pin, and this is for Kilimanjaro safaris, which is one of my favorite rides at Animal Kingdom because it's so cool. Mm-hmm. And this pin is gorgeous. I love this pin. And it's got a little giraffe in the back, which is part of why I had to get it, because I kind of collect giraffe pins. And it's so cute, but I love looking at the animals, and we're going to do a vlog probably here pretty soon where we get to go be wilderness explorers.
Yes!
And see all the animals and learn all the things.
Save nature.
So yeah, I love Animal Kingdom for its designated purpose. I also love it for rides, and the shows are incredible, but I really like the almost zoo element of it as well, and I think it's really cool. So,
yeah. So to go along with Abby's answer, something that I do way, way too often, and I shouldn't, is shopping! Well, it could be shopping. I think this is like half shopping, half eating in the parks.
Mm.
But I just chose a dollar bill pin.
Just spending money in the parks.
Spending money is a really, really bad time saver, but it's one of my favorite things to do. Even if I don't buy anything, I love to go look in the shops and like window shop. I love to eat in the parks. So I just chose this Disney dollar bill pin. This one has Mickey Mouse in the middle and it says Mickey one Disney dollar. This pin is from 2007, and it was part of a hidden Mickey pin collection, which I'm happy to say now I have the whole collection.
Yay!
Of this. There are 3 bills in the collection, and I have them all. So, yes, I'm very happy to have this, and this one's not going to leave my wallet like everything else. Alright, so we're nearing the end of this tag. There are 10 questions, but question 8 is a pin that represents your favorite Disney resort.
So for this one, I went with one of my biggest pins and what's one of my favorite pins, and that is this Starlight Safari pin from Animal Kingdom Lodge. Animal Kingdom Lodge is my favorite resort. Mm-hmm. It pretty much, like every time I walk in there, I'm just like,
it's like,
oh. It's so good. I love Old Key West. I love the one Hope's about to talk about in a second that I won't spoil unless you probably already know it because we never shut up about these. But I love Animal Kingdom Lodge, and this pin is so cool because it glows in the dark,
yeah,
which is amazing, and it's like up on my pin board in my room, and every night it just glows, and it makes me happy. But the Starlight Safari, I don't know if it's still going on, but it was like a thing that you could sign up to do in the resort, and they would take you, like, go look at the animals at nighttime, and it was really cool.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, this is a really cool pin, and again, it kind of goes in both my Animal Kingdom Lodge kind of mini collection that I've acquired, and also my giraffe mini collection that I'm working on. So
that's cool.
Yeah.
So my resort that I'm going to share, you guys I'm sure know by now, my favorite Disney resort of all time is the Beach Club. This is Disney's Beach Club Resort. It is the sister resort to the Yacht Club. They are like almost one, but they're technically 2 resorts, mm-hmm. but you can walk from one to the other by a connected hallway. But I absolutely love the Beach Club. It is by far my favorite. It honestly, like Abby was saying for Animal Kingdom Lodge, when you walk in, to me, it's just like instantly home.
Mm-hmm.
You just relax, you feel comfortable, you feel, you know, just really excited to be there. And it's a walking distance to Epcot, so we know that I love that. So this one is the official Beach Club Resort pin. It has flip-flops and some starfish,
it's a really
seahorse.
Cute pin. I like it.
It's an adorable beachy vibe mm-hmm. pin. And this one is an open edition from 2015. So, I love the beach club. Question 9. A pin that represents a character you would like to meet at the parks, but you haven't yet. So, earlier we shared our favorite character that we have met, and so this one is a pin that you have not met.
Character wish list, if you will. Yes. Meet and greet wish list. I have a few characters that I would like to meet that I either haven't met before or haven't met in a really long time. There's a few of those that it's been a while, like Mary Poppins I met once, but it's been like years.
Yeah, there have been quite a few that I've met in a while.
Yeah, but one that I haven't met yet, and it's kind of still shocking to me that I still haven't managed to find him anywhere, is the Beast. Now, we haven't eaten and be our guest since they started doing the Beast meet and greet. Mm-hmm. We ate not a long time ago, but like a while ago.
When it was new.
Yeah, but I've never met the Beast. I've met Belle several times, but I've never actually, like, hugged the Beast. And I feel like that's a thing I need to do in my life. Yeah. But this is the Funko Pop box lunch pin that went with Belle. But it's so cute, and I like it a lot. And yeah, so the Beast is definitely one that I need to meet sometime.
Well, my character that I would love to meet, I don't believe has a meet and greet, and I don't know that he ever has, but it kind of is very similar to Abby's in that Anna is my favorite character, but I would love to meet Kristoff. Particularly Kristoff and Anna together, mm-hmm. I think would be such a great couple meet and greet.
I think there was a while he was with Olaf at Hollywood Studios.
Okay.
When they took
But it was for like a limited time short thing. So unfortunately, I've never met him before. Mm-hmm. So I would absolutely love to do that. And like I said, with him and Anna together, I think would be hilarious. Mm-hmm. So to represent that, I'm showing this brand new open edition pin. This was just released a few weeks ago. And it's like this family portrait type pin that is all of the Frozen characters. So you have Anna, Elsa, Kristoff, Sven, and Olaf. They're all like crowding into the family picture, and then it's in this really pretty frame, so it looks like it would just be hung up like in their castle, mm-hmm. you know, as their family photo. So I love this pin, but yeah, I would love to meet Anna and Kristoff together. I think that would just be awesome. And the final question already is question 10. A pin that represents a Disney park you want to visit one day.
Ooh. So this is hard. We've never been to any other parks than Walt Disney World, so really any of them would be fine. I'd love, ideally, to go to Disneyland. I think that's the first one that's on our list. But I picked this really cute little suitcase pin that has all of the parks on the front, like little like stickers, as if that's where Mickey has
from every
been.
Place you
You've
go.
Been to a sticker every place you went. And inside, it's just got Mickey with his little suitcase. And it says, Around the World with Mickey, and it's got a hat and a suitcase,
so
and it's so cute. And it's got, like, almost like a rose gold backing to it, which I think is really pretty. But yeah, I'd love to go to all of these places. Shanghai, Paris, Hong Kong, Tokyo, Anaheim. And I mean, I don't need to go to Orlando, like...
But I will always go again.
But I will always go again anytime I get the chance.
As Abby said before, our number one destination we would love to go is Disneyland in Anaheim, California. We do hope to get there soon.
Yes.
But that is our number one place that we want to go. And so I am sharing this Disney Rewards pin from 2019. And this one has Mickey Mouse in his very fancy tux. He has like the tails and everything going on. And he is just jumping in front of Sleeping Beauty's castle in Disneyland. And it's just a really, really beautiful pin. And so, yeah, this one represents Sleeping Beauty's castle, which is in Disneyland. Mm-hmm. So we definitely would love to get to Disneyland sometime in the future. So that is it for our tag today. We hope that you guys have enjoyed this. Thank you so much to Cassidy for inviting us to do this with you. We are so proud of you. This is an awesome pin tag. And we're so happy to be part of it. So now it's time to tag some people, because this is a tag after all.
The first person that we would love to tag is our friend Holly from Holly Ever After. Holly is amazing, and she's just the sweetest person ever, and her channel is great. So you should go and check her out. And Holly, we're tagging you to do this.
Yep. Holly has been a longtime watcher of our channel, and now she's started a channel of her own. So we're so excited to see all of her collections. Like, we want to see everything. The next person that we would like to tag is Maria from Mouse People. She has some really, really cool pins, and so we would love to see you take part in this tag. Tag, you're it.
The next person we would like to tag is Liz from Just a Disney Nerd. She is a local just like us, and we know she loves pin collecting just like we do. So Liz, we'd love to see you do this tag as well.
And the final person we would like to tag, yes, we're tagging four because we can, we would like to tag Caitlin, aka Miss Disney Mama. You are tagged to do this as well. So we hope that you've enjoyed watching this tag. If you did, please give it a thumbs up.
Subscribe down below for more Disney magic. And if you want to do this tag,
we tag you.
Go for it. Do
it. Feel free to do this video and say that the Disney sisters tagged you. We are totally good with that, and we cannot wait to see.
Tag your it.
All of your videos. Be sure to hit the notification bell next to the subscription button so you don't miss any future pin content from us.
And we'll see you next time.
Bye.